Oh, that's a good one. Good morning. Good morning. Happy Sabbath. Happy Easter, or as we call it in my family, Happy Resurrection Day. Wanted to talk about today why I am so joyful. And why today is so important. I guess really why today is part and parcel in a humongous way to why I believe what I believe. Why I've surrendered my will to Jesus Christ. Basically, if what we're celebrating today hadn't occurred, the resurrection of Jesus Christ, a human being, divine and human, and I don't completely understand that whole part of it. It's very confusing. Mathematically impossible and so forth. But if this day had not occurred, then everything Christ would have said previous would have been a metaphor. Now, he spoke in parables a lot and talked a lot in metaphors and similes and so forth and whatnot in various rhetorical devices. But if this day had not occurred, then everything he said would have been a metaphor. Everything would have been, then he kind of would have been who a lot of people claim him as now, which is just a wise man and a teacher and, you know, just a great rabbi and an enlightened soul. But that's not who he said he was. He claimed, amongst all the wisdom dispensed by him, to be the Son of God and to be the fulfillment of a covenant made long ago with a small amount of people to illuminate the character of God. Big stuff, right? And then he died. He said that he would die for us to make us worthy of a relationship with God, to give us this almost easy peasy beautiful cover girl passageway to a relationship with God that required us to surrender our will, to turn from our own understanding, to turn from sin, to repent, as you often hear, and lean on him, to surrender to God and be embraced as a child of God. And I am just so grateful this morning for that, that path was made smooth, and that was Jesus Christ, you know, the man, the divine. That was his whole point of coming to earth, was to speak to us, speak to our hearts, and call us to the foot of God. And man, I just live every breath in gratitude of that. And I live just in joyful humility and gratitude today. And that, this moment we celebrate today, suffuses my entire life. And it suffuses my entire being. This is the moment where someone took for me, you know, jumped in front of the speeding train, they leapt in front of the firing squad, any other metaphor you want to throw at it, but he stood up for me, that I might not fail, and that all I do might not be a knot for naught. Man, and I'm just filled with that glory. That's what Easter is, you know? Is he is risen. And he is risen, and he lives in me. He can live in all of us. And that the Spirit of God itself empowers me daily, totally daily. If you've ever met me and found me joyful, that's why. And I hate to use evidentiary human means to explain just this glory, because it's really just about the surrendering of will and that death of ego and just living in joy and gratitude and obedience and servanthood to God and to others, and live as Christ lived. And that's what I celebrate today. Just celebrate beyond celebration. So happy Easter to all. Happy Resurrection Day. And peace and love, and God loves you. And in Christ was proof of that. And then Christ's resurrection was actually even further proof of that. To say, oh no, this wasn't just some crazy kook. He was either the Son of God, because that's what he said, or he was a kook. And nothing he said really should be taken seriously at all. But I found not only his words illuminating and joyfully releasing and wise, but his life as well. And his death is something even to model my life on, and how I can live for others beyond, to make my life a sacrifice to God and to others. And then he rose again from the grave, dead, now alive, and ascended to heaven. I know it sounds kooky, but there's a lot of kooky things that happen in this world. And there's a lot of things outside myself and way beyond myself and above myself that move in this world. And so really it's no small feat to be like, oh, okay, well, that's what he said he was going to do. And the things he has done in my life, he's also said he would do and has done. So it's actually kind of easy. Anyway, happy Easter. Enjoy your day. Enjoy some fellowship. God bless all of you so much.